Now, from the dusty streets of a poultry farming community just outside Worcester comes the soulful and refined personality that is Elwira Standili. From a young age, her dream was to become a singer, and in between working as a general worker to becoming a cleaner and then being a waitress, she still remained true to her dream and sang at every event that she could. So since entering one of the country's top singing competitions, Elwira is well on her way to becoming a household name. So let's have a look at one of her songs featuring Lois Obala, in which is a tribute to Tata Madiba.
And there's a struggle going on inside. Is this worth it for a nation? I did my way to you. Don't let the fire die. A small flame of hope has been ignited. I did my way to
not letting the fire die, whether it's on radio or on our TVs, we have the beautiful Elwira. Now, if you have any questions for Elwira, just connect with us online and remember to use the hashtag #AfternoonExpress in all of your comments. Welcome. Welcome, Queen.
Thank you so much for having me.
First of all, you look absolutely stunning, and I'm so looking forward to sharing the gift that you've blessed us with everyone watching at home.
Thank you, my love.
So you had such an interesting upbringing. I mean, you said basically in this poultry farm in Worcester, there was nothing but God and music.
Yes.
I mean, how was it like growing up in such a secluded area?
Yes, it's far from town, but it kept me. I think it kept me grounded. I grew up in a home where I have four other siblings, so I'm the middle child, and I think that's why I'm the only one doing what
Girl,
I'm doing.
That's me
you
too.
Know, because
middle children.
Yes, I'm in the middle, you know. So I'm trying to just pursue my dreams, but growing up there, and I grew up in a musical family. So we used to have these get-togethers, and before we departed, we had to sing a song. Whether it was We Bless Your Name or Alpha and Omega, whatever, there was somebody playing the guitar because we believed in music, and that kept us together. And then, of course, God, the giver of this gift that I have.
Absolutely. So coming together as a family was music. That's what brought you guys together. And then that's what connected you with the rest of South Africa.
Yes.
I mean, you entered one of the top singing competitions in the country. And, you know, it kept people saying, this is a voice that can unite nations, that can unite forces and bring people together.
That's amazing, and I thank you for that. And I don't even realize that when I sing. Wow. It's for me, because I never had any professional or training or whatever. This is just me opening my mouth and singing.
Wow.
Watching Benjamin Dube and Joy Celebration while growing up. And that's, I think that's all the influences that is now coming together in this one. This thing that I'm doing when I'm on stage.
I can imagine the sudden shot to fame that you experienced. I mean, how has it changed your life?
Oh, massively. I can remember, because growing up on a farm and then coming to this competition, and there's cameras and stuff everywhere. I remember I used to duck and dive when they came just to ask how I'm feeling, because I didn't know what to say. So just don't come near me.
You're like, no spotlights, please.
Please don't come. Like, I don't know how to explain. I have all these emotions because I come from this small town, and now I'm doing this and seeing other people that singing, and I adore them. You know, for me, it's that child, Natsika Sungyong. But and then doing this and having this experience, it was amazing. And
it seems like a goosebump moment, an out-of-body moment where you're just like,
definitely.
Is this me? So what has this journey taught you about yourself, taught you about yourself and your talent, and sharing it with the world?
Definitely that you don't know what you have until you use it. You don't know what gift you have or the impact that it can make before you use it. You need to do something about it. And that's what I always say when I talk to young people asking me, so how can I do this? I have this gift, but I do want to do something with it. You need to do something, you know,
just make
to get it.
Do the first step.
Exactly. You need to take that first step. And it really showed me that I'm actually very strong, you know, and I got that from my mama.
Yes,
you know?
Mama.
But it showed me that there's nothing impossible for me. Because I believe that I can do anything. And I still want to travel. I still want to sing everywhere, not just in South Africa.
Absolutely.
And I believe that I can do that because music is a connection.
Yeah, music is definitely a universal language. And it connects you to any and everyone.
Yes.
Not only are you strong and empowered within yourself, but heading into Women's Month, you've got an incredible initiative. Do it for the girls?
Do it for the girls. I'm so
Tell
excited
about
this. I'm so excited about this. This is just something that's very close to my heart. And I feel like, especially growing up on a farm, you know, that we didn't have much. We only had this little. And I grew up two girls.
Okay.
And then three boys. Mm. So we didn't have much, and I know, and so this is, let me start by saying that, Elwira. It's a initiative where I'm gonna donate or get sponsors or people to donate sanitary pads for girls. And if you see all around us, there's movements trying to get people to do that, because I know it's a struggle, you know?
It's expensive, it's a struggle, it changes your life.
It does, and it puts you in such a, yeah, you don't feel like you belong outside, you know? It keeps you in a corner. And I feel like I want to give girls their confidence back, you know, by doing this. So we're gonna raise funds. I'm going to do whatever I have to do.
Beautiful.
Even if I have to go sing at somebody's concert or somebody's whatever and raise these funds. I'm going to generate the money. I'm going to go ask people for it, because we all know that. We all know the struggle. And I feel like if there's somebody outside that wants to buy in or help little girls. Mm. And I'm gonna start by primary school, getting a few primary schools and going out to them and getting sponsors for the girls.
Well,
because
absolutely.
That's where it starts, actually.
Yeah, and the sky is the limit when it
exactly.
comes to doing it for the girls. I think there can never be enough initiatives that are geared in that way.
Exactly.
So we've been asking you on our social media platforms, the people wanna know, honey, if you've got any questions for Elwira. So we've got Julian here who asks you, what advice would you give someone who wants to enter into the music industry?
Thank you so much for the question, my love. First, know what it is you want to do. Know what it is that your genre of music is, you know? And then just going out and grabbing opportunities, because it's not going to come to you. It's not going to happen. So you need to go out and try and do something. Like, I entered a competition because I knew that that was going to be a platform for me to start somewhere. Mm. So just grab any opportunity you can get.
It goes back to how we said taking the first step. And
exactly.
I always say they can't hire you if they don't know you exist.
Come on.
Yourself very visible and don't be shy about your talent, Jillian. We've got one more comment here from Shireen Adams, who first says, hey girl, hey Elwira.
Hi love.
And what inspired you to go into the music industry? It's a very competitive industry. How do you cope?
Ooh, I can only say this one thing. I keep myself grounded by staying true to myself. I'm different to everybody you've ever seen. I'm crazy, but I can also, you know. and when I sing, people they can't connect the dots, because when I'm talking, I'm like this, but when I sing, it's serious business, and that's what you need to do. So I keep myself grounded by staying true to myself.
Absolutely. I mean, and true you are. Even when you are soulful, I still see Elwira coming through. We've got one more for you from Tasnim, and they're asking, what's your next show? Where can the people find you?
Tasnim! Are you talking about my own productions? Because I just had one. And then obviously I'm going to plan the next one for 2020.
Okay.
But I just had this. But you can just follow me on social media and check out where I am and
Absolutely.
Where I'm going to be and whatever.
And we'll also have all of her information up on Afternoon
yes.
Express's website. So just head over there online and you can check up and keep up to date to everywhere you can catch her performing.